Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, and this is Jehanzaib Amin with you. My today's session is related with the troubleshooting part, and this troubleshooting is for Cisco UCS BE6000 server. I have two physical BE6000 server currently running with my Cisco Unified Call Manager application, including Unity and IAM presence on the two server, one as a publisher and one as a subscriber, as a two separate individual hardware. All of a sudden, I found that my applications which were hosted on my subscriber went down on a second server. And during the initial investigation, I found that there is some issue with the physical disk. Problems can be happen anytime, anywhere, in any environment with your either Cisco servers, either with your router, switches, or whatever device. But the thing is that how you will do the troubleshooting part and your initial investigation. So my today session is related for those guys who face a problem with their Cisco UCS servers, either blade server or either it is a rack mount server. So how you will do your initial investigation? The initial investigation you will do with one file which is called ShowTech. ShowTech is available with all Cisco hardwares, either it is router, switches, or a wireless controller, or your servers. With the help of ShowTech, you will find out what is the root cause of this problem, and especially when you have to open RMA claim with the Cisco, if your devices are under the warranty or you have a smart net, then Cisco will always ask for the ShowTech. With the help of ShowTech, they find out that either this problem is based on the hardware or on the software. If it is software, Cisco will do the troubleshooting part and they will fix it. But if this is an issue with the hardware, for sure you will go for the replacement, and for the replacement you need a ShowTech which Cisco will ask you and you will provide them. So I will show you that how you will generate a ShowTech from the Cisco UCS server. Other than this one, I will explain you regarding some other feature related with the ShowTech, and that is called CIMC. How you will get the ShowTech? You will get with the physical hardware software which is called CIMC, stand for Cisco Integrated Management Console. This is you can say this is just like a BIOS of a Cisco UCS server, which is related purely with the hardware. What kind of hardware, what software is there, what kind of component, it is a complete GUI inventory for your Cisco UCS server. So I will show you how you will connect with your CIMC, and how we will generate the ShowTech and some other information. So let's start our lab for today. But before connecting with my CIMC, I will show you that how I will I find out that my VMs went down, and this one I will do it with my hypervisor, which is E6i. So let's start our lab and we will explore some other things related with the CIMC, which is called Cisco Integrated Management Console. Thank you. So if you see this, this is my BE6000 UCS server, and currently I'm running my unified applications for the Cisco Call Manager, Cisco Unity, and the Cisco subscriber. So my all servers have been down and showing is as invalid. This is the reason because of the disk failure. Only my one subscriber is running normally, and the remaining my CUPA cups subscriber, Express C2, Express E2, and some other servers is down right now. Okay, and if I check here in the storage side, I will see that local Cisco disk is error. So 1.36 TB of my disk, which is as a RAID, okay, has been filled now. So I will see now that what's the problem happen exactly. But before that one, I will shut down my existing running my subscriber for Cisco Call Manager. I will keep it shut it down with the command, and then I will show you that how we will collect the ShowTech
from the BE6000 physical server. So the first thing, I will connect with my CM subscriber. And I think my subscriber is also not reachable because of this disk failure. Okay, you can see it just showing me power on, but I'm not able to log in from the command line. I will check second thing with my this server. No. Okay. So what happened exactly? Because of the disk failure, I am running on my my publisher, my Cisco Call Manager publisher. So my subscriber is down right now. So I will check to connect it through the GUI, and I will see if I'm able to log in or not. So guys, you see that I have lost connectivity with my subscriber. I'm not able to log in even from the GUI and from the CLI. So the thing what I will do right now, I will just shut it down straightforward from here. I'll make it power off. Okay. Same thing I will do with my CUBS subscriber. Power off. Okay. So finally, what I found at this moment that my whole disk failed and my RAID is also down. So my all servers are physically down, but my environment is running quite well because I have parallel another publisher. I will show you over here, my servers. Okay, so this is my active server. My all publisher are running very fine. So that's why I don't face any downtime. And this is the reason we always go as a redundant or high availability setup for our any production environment. But in Cisco Call Manager, we have this feature as a publisher and subscriber. This is always exist only for this reason that if your one server is down or your app is down, so you have a parallel setup and your production will not be disturbed. Okay, so I have shut down my all the servers. Now I will go in my data center and I will connect my BE6000 with CIMC. Okay, on the CIMC, I will connect with the physical server and I will collect the logs for the ShowTech from there. Okay, so my all server is now showing as invalid. Before going to the physical server, I will just tell you about CIMC. What is CIMC? CIMC stands for Cisco Integrated Management Console. And normally with the help of CIMC, you connect the physical hardware with the help of CIMC to manage your disk, to manage your server, to upgrade or downgrade or any issue. If you face, you will just connect CIMC. There is a port, specific port available at the back of Cisco UCS servers. And with that one, you will just provide the management IP. So it is always recommended to keep connected your CIMC console with your network so you can access it from the CLI or from the GUI. In my case, what happened? I did not connect my CMC with my network. So ultimately, now I'm not able to connect the physical management console over the network with the GUI or with the PuTTY. So I have to do another one ahead step to connect the CMC. What I will do, I will just put one monitor and with the keyboard and mouse, I will just reboot it and I will try to recover my CIMC. And after that, I will show you that how I will take the ShowTech and I will explain you some other things also in the CIMC. Stay tuned and I will continue with my data center inside to connect a monitor with the keyboard and mouse to recover the CIMC. Thank you. So guys, let's move inside the data center and I will show you BE6000 server and how to connect the LCD to check the CIMC IP which is configured already, but I did not remember
because I did not connect it over the network. So I will see how I can recover the IP address, and then which port is connected for the CIMC. And then finally, we will connect over the network with the CIMC IP address and collect the showtech. So let's move inside data center. This is, we put it sticky mat to control the dust. And then there is a glass door to control the temperature. So I place this keyboard and LCD monitor to connect with my BE6000 server. This is my BE6000 server, and I will connect it with my LCD monitor with the help of this console cable, serial console. Okay, so what I will do now, I will connect it over here like this. I will connect it over like this one. Okay, and then I will take my this cable for my LCD monitor, and I will connect it with my this port. Okay, so I will just connect over here, and I will do it F12 shutdown restart. Okay, I will press here F12. It will ask me the username and password. I will just mention the password. Okay, and I will do it as a F11. I'll press it F11. Okay, and the process is started now. So finally, my BE6000 server is going to be shut down, restart, and then I will press F2. This is the key, F2. Okay, as soon as it is shut down, I'll press it F2. And I found this one IP address for my CIMC. This is my CIMC IP address, 2022.40.162. Okay, because of pressing F2, this key. Okay, so let me show you the back side, where is the port. So this is my server B6000 backport, and this is the two ports for the network, 1 and 2, and this is the CIMC port. Okay, this is my CIMC port.